डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डायरेक्टर एजुकेशन SDPC डॉक्टर तेजिंदर कौर तालीवाल जी, डिप्टी डायरेक्टर प्रोफेसर प्रभजीत सिंह जी, रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल दशमेश खालसा कॉलेज जीरकपुर डॉक्टर करमवीर सिंह जी, गैलेक्सीज ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल्स फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड द पार्टिसिपेंट्स फ्रॉम ऑल द डिफरेंट कॉलेजेस अक्रॉस इंडिया, आई वेलकम यू ऑल. Research cell of Dashmesh Khalsa College envisioned a faculty development program where the experienced professionals could share their expertise with the teacher fraternity concerning their teaching practices in actual and virtual classrooms. I feel exultant in admitting that we sustained that vision. The feedback forms of the participants are the testimony of the success of this event. No plan can take shape without a diligent leader. On behalf of research cell of the Dashmesh Khalsa College, I am thankful to Director Education Dr. Tejinder Kaur Taliwal ji for considering and supporting our proposal of organizing FDP wholeheartedly. The person who gave us the belief to bring together this program is our worthy principal, Dr. Karamveer Singh ji. It was his dedication and enthusiasm which made this event a huge success. Let us not forget the backbone of this grand function, the team, who went an extra mile and worked their tail off, made this dream a reality. Special thanks to Madam Manveen Kaur and Madam Mala Malik. I would also like to acknowledge Dr. Himanshu Agarwal, Dr. Tanya Mandir, Dr. Biba Booth, Dr. Gurleen Aluwalia, Dr. Bhupinderjeet Kaur, Dr. Shalini Thakur, Madam Paramjeet Kaur, Dr. Daljeet Singh and Dr. Ankdeep Kaur Atwal are esteemed speakers who took the time out of their busy schedules and shared us with their pearls of wisdom and knowledge. We are truly humbled by their talk. Thank you all once again. Furthermore, let's have a special recognition to all the participants who inspired us all with their positive feedback. Thank you so much for being our pillars of support. The end of a story is the new beginning for many others. On this note, let us conclude a remarkable, memorable, and knowledgeable event. On the behalf of research cell of the Dashmesh Khalsa College, we sincerely promise you that in the coming years too, we will keep on organizing such proceedings related to the field with more innovative ideas to nourish your mind and fill you with more knowledge. Now let's have the pleasure of listening to the concluding remarks of Assistant Director SDPC Professor Prabhjit Singh ji, and after that I would request Madam Mala Malik to propose vote of thanks.
Sat Sri Akal, Namaskar, my dear friends on this who are attending this faculty development program. I am a strong believer that when we fold hands in front of someone, the sense of humility is so much that I have practically experienced that half the battle is won, and we are able to develop a sense of belongingness with that fellow in front of whom we are folding our hands. I am thankful to my friend Dr. Karamveer Singh, Principal Dashmesh Khalsa College, Zirakpur, who has given me this opportunity to be with all of you on the concluding session of this 5-day faculty development program. I have been conveyed that we have an audience from different parts of India, and even few people have joined outside India. So on behalf of Directorate of Education, Shromani Gurudwara Prabandhak Committee, on behalf of our Dashmesh Khalsa College, I am thankful to all of you who have taken this opportunity to develop their skills, to learn. Friends, development leads to growth. And as a teacher, it should be our continuous endeavor to grow, to develop, to learn. While working at Directorate of Education and managing more than 90 educational institutions, we come across, while going for the recruitment, we throughout the year, we come across the candidates who want to be a teacher. And when we ask them that which was the last book which you have read, then the usual answer is the book which they have read while doing their post-graduation and which was part of their curriculum. Once we become a teacher, the major issue is that we stop learning. And when we stop learning, that is the end of our intellect. That is the death of our intellect, because if we are not growing, then I don't see that the students to whom we are teaching, they will grow. So learning has to be a continuous process, which as a teacher, all of us must adopt. We are in such a profession that it is an entirely different from any other profession. We are dealing with lives. We are dealing with the lives. Life, our product is a life. And it is entirely different from a person who is working in a factory or in any office, you can say. Because if a product is defective, having some manufacturing defect, then we can just throw it. But if we are, as a teacher, if I am not justifying my role, if I am not teaching in such a way that a student comes out to be a better human being, then his or her entire life is changed. So the onus lies on us that we teach, and we teach through learning, and we should continuously be striving to learn throughout our life. We must be proud of our profession in order to grow, in order to succeed, and we must enjoy our profession. I have seen people whom, in majority of the situations, they are teachers by chance and not by choice. But I am a teacher, not by chance. It was a choice. I got selected in an MBA for an MBA degree also, but I preferred this so because teaching is my passion. Now the thing is that once we have become a teacher, now we have to inculcate passion into that teaching. We must enjoy our teaching. We should not take it like a liability that so that we stop working or we put our performance in the fourth gear. Because I always say to my teachers of various schools and colleges that you should behave, you should teach a student in the similar manner in which you want your son or daughter is to be taught by some other teacher. So we are the ones, it is a very difficult task. It is very difficult. Teaching is not an easy thing, and to be a teacher, whom in our Indian culture we call a guru, to be a guru or to be a teacher, this is the most toughest profession. I consider it the most toughest profession. You will see many people, high-ranked people in the administrative services and all that, who cannot speak for even 10 minutes. And we are the ones who deliver lecture after lecture for so many years. We have been giving or delivering the lectures. So we are the ones who are making those administrative positions. We are making bankers, we are making CAs and all that, we are making doctors. So we must relish it. We must enjoy our profession. We must give due justification to our performance. If we fail to do that, then my dear friends, I'm sorry to say, we are not teachers. We should not be, we have no right to call ourselves teacher. If I am not in a position to deliver, if I am not in a position to change the life of the 30 or 40 students whom I am teaching and whom I am touching their lives, and I have each and every responsibility towards their future, and I have to deliver it in such a way that I come close to my fulfillment of my responsibility. We belong to Sikhism, and the first Guru, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, he gave us three golden, you can say, golden rules or principles. In Punjabi, it is said, Kirt karo, naam japo, te pand chako. Honestly, in English, it means that honestly earn your livelihood, pray to the God, and share your earnings with others. My dear friends, honestly earning our livelihood, that has to be the golden rule, which I always preach. I always say in my lectures that we, the teachers, have to adapt. It is not the routine teaching. It is not the just going to your institution at 9 and coming back at 3. And then nothing is to be done for your institution, nothing is to be done for your students, for your fellow colleagues. No, that is not an earnest livelihood. That is not an honest livelihood. We have been only delivering our duty. We have been only maintaining the. We are just coming close to the formality, but we are not into teaching. At least we are not into learning procedure. At least the honest earning is when whatever I do before 9 or after 3 for my fellow colleagues, for my institution, and above all for my students. So if you are helping your student after that span of 3, then only you have the right to say that I am earning my duty, I am performing my duty honestly. But if you restrict it only to those 5 hours, and after those 5 hours you are not ready to take any assignment given by your principal or your institution or your management, or you are not ready to even connect on a telephone with your boss or with your head of the department or with your principal, then I am sorry to say that I don't consider that as per our Guruji's saying, you are doing your duty honestly. Honestly doesn't mean that one has not to be corrupt or to involve in such practices which lead to corruption. Honesty is in delivering your duties, in delivering your activities with par excellence. When you are concerned with the future of your students, when you are concerned with the future of your institute. And I tell you, if you belong, if you feel concerned for your students, for your institutions, it is directly related with the your own personal growth, because institutions grow, and along with the institutions, the individuals who are related with those institutions, they also grow. I have not come across any such situation or any such example where institutions have not grown but individuals have grown. No, our growth, growth of a teacher, the career of a teacher, it is entirely and directly related with the growth of the students of that institution, with the growth of the institution itself. If you will grow only when your institutes will grow, when they will shine, when there will be work culture, only then you will also shine. So it is my humble submission to you that just enjoy your profession, feel proud of your profession, and work for your profession. Go for learning, go for better listening. Most of listening is very important aspect, which I always say that a teacher must be taken care of. Mostly we develop the habit of conveying only, because we deliver lectures day to day, and we in doing that we become a poor listener, and we are not ready to listen what my student is saying, and we are not ready to listen what my colleague is saying, and if I say we are not ready to listen what my head of the institution is saying, even that is correct. But my dear friends, each one has every role, each one is playing every role. Your principal, your head of the department, your colleagues, they are also playing their role, and at least we must give them a patient hearing, and we must make a sincere effort of considering or trying to see their perspective, because they are also having a responsibility to share. My submission to you is that we belong to such a profession which is a class apart. You really enjoy when 40 or 50 students are listening to you. You really enjoy when you know that these are the people who will become someone, who will be leading us, who are our future. And we must do our duty as a teacher honestly and with utmost passion, so that we are able to deliver the best, and our students, they excel. It is just like when a student touches your feet and conveys that, sir, ma'am, I have become an officer in a company, believe me, it gives such a sense of relief, it gives such a sense, you really feel proud that there is someone who gives the credit of his success to you as a teacher. And if we talk about this current situation of Corona, our duties have multiplied. Because specifically, I must convey my gratitude from this platform to our female staff who have to take care of the household, as well as they have been constantly in touch with their students through and giving online teaching and learning to them. It is a new experience to all of us, and it is going to stay. The online learning is going to stay for the coming years or for in the future. We have to adopt it. And as far as SGPC is concerned, we are seriously thinking of having a dedicated learning management software so that we can provide it to our educational institutions. I request you all through this platform, through this faculty development program, that make a sincere beginning of developing your own online resources. Many of you, I'm sure, have been doing it also. But I request a dedicated and a technically strong, because all these sources, they are not so secure. You have to go for dedicated learning management softwares. Many of them are free of cost, and for many others you have to pay. But you just ask your managements, you just ask your institutions to provide you with that learning management software, so that we can provide teaching. I am a strong believer of this fact, that classroom teaching cannot be substituted in any way, because classroom teaching has been in a practice thousands of years. We have been following it, and no matter whatever is the situation, classroom teaching is going to stay. But we have to strengthen our classroom teaching with online teaching by all means. You will come across a situation in the coming period that many of the courses, they would be offered online. So that for that also, we should be fully prepared, and we should go for those courses for our students. You can recommend your managements to opt for those courses also. It is a great opportunity for sharing my views. I am thankful to my friend Dr. Karambir Singh, my management, and to you all that you have given me this opportunity to be with you at the concluding session. Once again, I am thankful to all of you. Thank you very much. Sat Sri Akal. Namaskar.
An ignited mind is the most powerful weapon on the earth, above the earth and under the earth. And it is our education that ignites our mind. Education is the most profitable investment for the near future. A very good afternoon to everyone. Myself, Assistant Professor Mala Malik, working in the Department of Computer Science at Dashmesh Khalsa College, Zirakpur. It was indeed a very enriching and a learning experience for all of us to be a part of this 5-day online faculty development program on new pedagogies, a creative learning and creative teaching, a futuristic approach. On the behalf of Dashmesh Khalsa College, I wish to express my gratitude to our patrons, SGPC President Sardar Gobind Singh Ji Longowal, our Education Secretary Sardar Mohinder Singh Ji Ahli, our Director Education Dr. Tejinder Kaur Dhaliwal, and our Deputy Director Dr. Prabjit Singh, for providing encouragement to carry out with the idea of this faculty development program. Here, I must mention a deep sense of appreciation for our learned contributors, Dr. Himanshu Agarwal, Dr. Tanya Mandir, Dr. Ankdeep Kaur Atwal, Dr. Vibha Bhut, Ms. Paramjit Kaur, Dr. Shalini Thakur, Dr. Gurleen Aluwalia, Dr. Bhupinderjit Kaur, and Dr. Daljeet Singh, for giving an excellent coverage to the theme of the faculty development program. We are all inspired by your great words. I would like to take this opportunity to place a hearty thanks to our principal, Sir Dr. Karambir Singh, for the support and guidance he has extended to us. I also extend my thanks to our Dean Academic, Mrs. Manveen Kaur, and Convener Research Cell, Mrs. Amanpreet Kaur, for their enormous cooperation in organizing this event. Finally, I wish to express my sincere thanks to the building blocks of this FTP, are active participants, our fellow faculty members. This program was by the faculty, of the faculty, and for the faculty. I hope the faculty development program has resulted in an increase in your learning curve. It's a pleasure to go through your feedbacks. Thanks to all of you for contributing to the success of this program. Thank you.